It's time for our daily devotion. Daily, abiding in Jesus Christ. In the book of John chapter 15 verse 7. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. A daily devotional ministry project of Christo Doginogaga from passages taken from the Holy Scriptures with quotations from the Spirit of Prophecy by Ellen G. White. Daily, abiding in Jesus Christ.
June 8, 2020. Luke 15 verses 11 to 32. Verse 11. And he said, A certain man had two sons, 12, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. 13. And not many days after the younger son gathered all together, and took his journey into a far country, and there wasted his substance with riotous living. 14. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land, and he began to be in want. 15. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into his fields to feed swine. 16. And he would fain have filled his belly with the husks that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. 17. And when he came to himself, he said, How many hired servants of my father's have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger. 18. I will arise and go to my father, and will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven, and before thee. 19. And am no more worthy to be called thy son, make me as one of thy hired servants. 20. And he arose, and came to his father. But when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him, and had compassion, and ran, and fell on his neck, and kissed him. 21. And the son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven, and in thy sight, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. 22. But the father said to his servants, Bring forth the best robe, and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand, and shoes on his feet. 23. And bring hither the fatted calf, and kill it, and let us eat, and be merry. 24. For this my son was dead, and is alive again, he was lost, and is found. And they began to be merry. 25. Now his elder son was in the field, and as he came and drew nigh to the house, he heard music and dancing. 26. And he called one of the servants, and asked what these things meant. 27. And he said unto him, Thy brother is come, and thy father hath killed the fatted calf, because he hath received him safe and sound. 28. And he was angry, and would not go in, therefore came his father out, and entreated him. 29. And he answering said to his father, Lo, these many years do I serve thee, neither transgressed I at any time thy commandment, and yet thou never gavest me a kid, that I might make merry with my friends. 30. But as soon as this thy son was come, which hath devoured thy living with harlots, thou hast killed for him the fatted calf. 31. And he said unto him, Son, thou art ever with me, and all that I have is thine. 32. It was meet that we should make merry, and be glad, for this thy brother was dead, and is alive again, and was lost, and is found.
Quotation from the Spirit of Prophecy. What a picture in this story of the prodigal son of the sinner's state. Although surrounded with the blessings of his love, there is nothing that the sinner, bent on self-indulgence and sinful pleasure, desires so much as separation from God. Whatever the appearance may be, every life centered in self is squandered. Whoever attempts to live apart from God is wasting his substance. The love of God still yearns over the one who has chosen to separate from him, and he sets in operation influences to bring him back to the Father's house. The young man turns from the swineherds and the husks pods, and sets his face toward home. Trembling with weakness and faint from hunger, he presses eagerly on his way. He has no covering to conceal his rags, but his misery has conquered pride, and he hurries on to beg a servant's place where he was once a child. But while he is yet a great way off, the father discerns his form. Love is of quick sight. He had compassion, and ran, and fell on his neck in a long, clinging, tender embrace. In his restless youth, the prodigal looked upon his father as stern and severe. So those who are deceived by Satan look upon God as hard and exacting. His law they regard as a restriction upon men's happiness, a burdensome yoke from which they are glad to escape. But he whose eyes have been opened by the love of Christ will behold God as full of compassion. He does not appear as a tyrannical, relentless being, but as a father longing to embrace his repenting son. Arise and go to your father. He will meet you a great way off. If you take even one step toward him in repentance, he will hasten to enfold you in his arms of infinite love. And heaven and earth shall unite in the Father's song of rejoicing, for this my son was dead, and is alive again, he was lost, and is found. By Ellen G. White, Christ Object Lessons, pages 200-207.
Our prayer for today. Dear God, our loving Father in heaven, it is with profound humility to approach your holy presence. We are sinners by nature. Please, dear Father in heaven, in the name of Jesus Christ, please forgive all of us of our sins. Thank you for answering our prayers of forgiving our sins and for the indwelling of the Holy Spirit in us, because we present to our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.